Hello YouTube. Today we will be covering about data tables. So what data tables are? They are a container in which we can store some kind of structured data. So for example, I've created a very simple data set for the sake of this tutorial, and it is storing some string field and some integers. So I'll show an example of retrieving data from this. So I've created a very simple blueprint data parser, and it takes argument as an index as in like which row I want to receive. So let's say I received 0, so I think so gave 0 25 as some address. If I change it to let's say 3 and play again, then I'm getting same. So that is like third index. And if I let's say kept it like 50, I have like kept a very simple check for out of bound indexes, so I'll get error saying not valid data. So yeah, this is how, what we are going to create in this one. So I'll recreate something like this from scratch. So first thing that we need to do is go into blueprints and create a structure. So let's just say so what we can add here is let's say some string. So name, and it should be a string, and let's say some date or ID. So ID could be an integer, and what I will say, I've kept age. Okay, so then have age also an integer, and last field was address. So address, and here we go to the string. So this is like we created a very simple structure. You can also store things that are native to Unreal. Let's say some actor reference if you want. So actor, I can have an actor. So actor object reference, or if you want, let's say some texture. So just say text. And here you can have a texture 2D reference. So basically all the data that should be binded together, you can create a structure for it, and then inside data tables you can organize them in a particular format, and then you can retrieve that data back. So yeah, like for the sake of this tutorial, we won't be keeping actor and textures. You can keep them, but for displaying purposes I'm not keeping them. So yeah, we can start with this. So after creating this structure, what you can do is go to miscellaneous and data tables and select the structure that you want. So I'm keeping test writing and name it something like demo, and what you'll get is you'll get all the name fields and all. So let's just say this should be row 1. I'll keep the name as Newton. ID would be 0. Let's just keep it together. Address was, I guess, England. So, yeah. Now we can add another field. No name. Let's keep Einstein. ID 1, age, name the 60. He was German, so German. And let's just keep one more. Okay, so the real name would be 2. One name would be for this, let's say 3. For other scientists, I can be not Tesla, so Nikola. ID would be 2. He is, let's say, 70. Address, he was an American, so America. This should be a country instead of address, but yeah, let's keep it that way. And like after you do this, you can go to blueprint, create another blueprint, let's say bp underscore data table receiver or something. So yeah, now what we can do is on begin play, like I'm for demonstration purposes I'm using begin play. You can have your custom events pass this. So you can go to get data table row names, that is one thing, and get data table row. So what get data table row names does is basically goes into this and receive all the names, row names basically. So these are the identifier that it uses, and what this will do is I'll show all the row names that we have kept, like 1, 2, 3. These are the identifiers for this. So what we can do is we can get an array. So let's generate a copy, and on begin play I'm using this. I can get this, and here I'm passing this. So for this I can promote it to a variable, which is say index. I can spell it correctly. Index. And after that I can output the row, break the structure, and let's just say I'll print the string, and we get a fancy green color, just last a bit longer, and let's just append the string. This goes here, this goes here, this goes, let's say here, this goes here, put that a space in between. Format it a bit, it doesn't look that odd. Yeah, here we go. And what we can do now is, yeah, just place that actor, and I'll remove the old actor and I'll place the new one. For that, we can check that, and I forgot to make it instance editable. So, instance editable. So, now if I press play, I get Newton 055 and England. Now, if I go to 2, which was the last index, I'll get some other index. But so, if I go to 5 right now, it won't give us anything. So, what this is doing is it is getting this and trying to get this, but the row would not be bound. So, as a good programmer, we should be catching this thing, because it might cause some errors. So we can throw kind of an exception. This is not like exception handling, but in blueprints you can use this way. So we can say row not bound, and make it a red color so that it looks like an error. The row is not bound, and the channel like return doesn't work. One should work, and it does. So yeah, that was a basic tutorial on data tables. And as always, thank you for watching.